all of God's family that's gathered here in the house today. I give worship and praise to God for you. Amen. Whatever the title may be, if you deserve honor, just reach up, grab some. Amen. Fix that issue of life. And call somebody. Amen. If you deserve honor, what? Pull it down. Hallelujah. It's yours. Hallelujah. If you have your Bibles, amen, let us turn, amen, to the Gospel of St. Luke, the 7th chapter. Amen. 7th chapter. Amen. The Gospel of St. Luke. Amen. And my topic today is Speak the Word of God.
And
my subtitle would be, We as Believers Have Authority. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 7. Amen. Verse 1. Hallelujah. Now when he had ended all his sayings in the audience of the people, he entered into Capernaum, and a certain centurion, a servant was dear to him, was sick and ready to die. And when he had heard of Jesus, amen to God, he heard of Jesus, amen, sent unto him the elders of the Jews, beseeching him that he would come and heal his servant. And when they came to Jesus, they besought him instantly, saying that he was worthy for whom he should do this. For he loveth our nation, and he hath built us a synagogue. Then Jesus went with them, and when he was now not far from the house, the centurion sent forth to him, saying unto him, Lord, trouble not thyself, for I am not worthy that thou shouldest enter under my roof. Verse 7, wherefore, neither thought I myself worthy to come unto thee, but say in a word, and my servant shall be healed. For I also am a man set under authority, having under me soldiers, and I say unto one, come, go, and he goeth, and to another, come, and he cometh. And to my servant, do this, and he doeth it. When Jesus heard these things, amen to God, he marveled at him, and turned him about, and said unto the people that followed him, I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. And they that were sent returned to the house, found the servant whole that was or had been sick. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. People of God, amen. We have authority. Amen. We're born again. Amen to God. We have the authority, amen, that Jesus Christ, amen, came, amen, died for us, was buried, but rose again the third day, according to the scripture. Amen. To get back what he first gave to the first man, Adam. When Adam, amen, committed high treason in the garden, amen, he gave the authority that God gave him when he created him out of the dust of the ground and blew into his nostrils, man became a living soul. Amen to God. That's when the authority passed. You see, the scripture says, amen, that thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. See, God wants his will, amen, to be done in the earth realm. Amen. Just like it is as in heaven. So that's going to take what? Some authority. Some people walking in the earth, up and down in it, amen to God, with authority, amen, proclaiming the word of God and believing the word of God and watching Jesus, amen, bring his word to pass. Jesus said that my word is quick, it's alive, and it's powerful, amen to God. It is so sharp it can cut and divide soul and spirit. Get down to the bone and marrow of a man. In other words, the secret place, the hidden place, amen, that you can't see. All we can see is the outside. But when the word of God goes forth with power and demonstration of God, and the anointing is on it, amen, it gets down into a man or a woman. And man can put on a, what, face. He can put on a face on the outside and look good. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But what's really going on in the inside? Amen. The seed of God has been sown forth in it. And it will, Jesus said, my word will not return unto me void. Hallelujah. But it will accomplish that which I sent it into. Amen. It will be pleasing in my sight. Hallelujah. God needs some people, amen, that's going to believe his word. Amen to God. You're born again. Amen to God. You have authority. We're talking about a centurion, a Roman centurion. And he's not even an Israel of life. He's not even a Jew. Amen to God. Hallelujah. You understand what I'm saying? He's not even in the family of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he had faith enough. Amen. He heard about what Jesus has done and what Jesus can do. That's like the word is going forth now. You hear what the word of God can do and what Jesus has done. Can you remember the story about Rahab? And she said that, amen, we heard what God had done to Agag and God. And fear came upon all of us. Amen. And we over here trembling. Amen. Amen. With Joshua, and then we're going to come take the land. Amen to God. Hallelujah. You understand what I'm saying? The word of God has power. Power. Amen. A centurion. He was a Roman officer. He was a man, amen, in authority. And he was a man under authority. He had people on top of him, but he also had people under him. So he knew what authority is. Amen to God. And he saw the authority in Jesus. When Jesus spoke, things happened. Win, peace, be still. Hallelujah. And he was calm. Hallelujah to God. Man, take up your bed and walk. Hallelujah. He got up, took up his bed, and the thing that was carrying him, I mean, he started carrying. Hallelujah to God. Hallelujah. Amen to God. Hallelujah. Come on, let's say amen. We need to realize, amen to God, we are men and women of God. We have authority. A lot of us, and the devil wants us to believe, we don't have any authority. Poor me. Poor me. And the devil made me do it. I can't do nothing about my situation. But the word of God says you can. If this unbelieving, amen, a centurion, amen to God, who wasn't even a Jew in the family of God, if he can believe, surely the people of God can. Hallelujah. You can believe God for great and mighty things. Amen. He said, I show you great and mighty things. Just call upon me, and I show you great and mighty things. Hallelujah to God. Jesus said, when the word of God said in the book of Genesis, God spoke. Hallelujah. He said, let there be, let there be, there was. Amen. Don't get scared by the tongues. Amen. Don't run out the door. Amen. It's just a heavenly language. Amen to God. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm getting faster from heaven, okay? Amen to God. Hallelujah. Ha, ha. Hey, come on, stop. Jesus said that there be light, and there was light, man. Hallelujah to God. Let the field bring forth, amen. Let the waters of the sea bring forth whales and fish and so forth and so on. Amen. And it happened. And he said, on the sixth day, he made man. Hallelujah to God. Man is his crown creation. Mankind, male and female, is God's crowning creation. Hallelujah. He said, let them have dominion. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let them have dominion. Amen to God. Hallelujah. That means to rule. Amen to God. To rule. Amen. Not over each other, but to rule the things, amen, that I placed in the earth realm. I gave you authority over. Hallelujah. He said, he spoke. But you know what? Amen. God made us in his image. And in his likeness. Amen to God. Amen. Pray.
That's fine.
Pray. Amen to God. Hallelujah. He made us a spirit. A speaking spirit. Bible says in John 4 that God is a spirit. Those who worship him must worship in the spirit and in truth. Amen to God. He made us spiritual beings. Amen to God. So that we can rule in the earth for him. Hallelujah. See, Satan, the devil is big and bad. He's selling wolf tickets. You see? And we are so afraid of dying. See, that's the biggest bully on the block, is death. Amen. And see, what you get a man who ain't afraid to die, and ain't nothing you can do with him. Nothing you can do with him, he's afraid to die. Amen to God. That's why they find planes and the buildings and stuff. Amen to God. You understand what I'm saying? Because they're not afraid to die. They got some crazy promise about some 70 virgins and they're going to heaven and all this stuff. Amen. You understand? They think they're going to meet 70 virgins in heaven. They'll have a harem and all this, you know, that's ludicrous. But they flying planes in the buildings because they're not afraid to die. And how many of us, amen to God, amen, are afraid or not afraid to die?
All right.
See, for Christians, for us to die is gain. Amen to God. It's a doorway. Amen. That we all got to enter into. Amen. Unless the Jesus comes first and raptures us out. Raptures the church out. Amen. It's a doorway. Amen to God. We must enter through that doorway of death. Everybody wants to go to heaven. Nobody wants to die. Glory to God. Hey, glory to God. Centurion, man under authority. I believe Pastor Ruffin. Amen. Is a man under authority and in authority. Hallelujah. He's under God's authority. That God made him the shepherd of this great house. Amen to God. Hallelujah. And then he's in authority. Amen. It's like the Bible tells us to honor them who have to rule over us. Amen. And obey them. Amen. And it may go well with you. Amen. Because we have to give an account for you. Amen. In other words, I don't have to give an account for where you're going. But when I go to God in prayer about you, I got to give an account. You see, I'm not saying, Lord, send me five more good saints like that. Or am I saying, Lord, this one here. Oh, Lord, this one here is dependable, God. See, I'm giving you account for you. See, we take that scripture out of context and we make it say something that it's not saying. I'm not watching over you out for your soul. You do got to watch out for your soul. You follow what I'm saying? You got to accept Jesus for yourself or not. Amen to God. I can't get you to heaven on my back. I'm going to heaven with Jesus' back. Amen to God. Hallelujah. Amen to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. But look, we are speaking spirits. Hallelujah. I can speak the word of God. I can speak and believe God that he will do the work. Jesus said, I only say that which I hear the Father saying. I'm up here now, I'm listening to what the word the Father is saying. So I may say to you, amen. I only do that which I see the Father do, Jesus said. Amen. And so Jesus left it on record for us, amen, what the Father is doing and what the Father is saying. So if I speak what he spoke, amen to God, I can expect to receive what the word of God said. I want to encourage you today. You are a speaking spirit. Open your mouth. Hallelujah.